Why is water so incompressible? Let's untangle in this video. Well, water is also compressible, but its compressibility is very negligible. Like, if you pressurize 100 ml of water at around 10,000 bar, it will reduce to around 97 milliliters, only reduction of 3%. So, it's considered as incompressible. But what makes the water so hard to compress? For that, first, let's understand what is compressibility. Compressing something means applying pressure to reduce the volume so that the density of the material increases, bringing the molecules even closer to each other. Water is very hard to compress because it is already compressed. Its molecules are very close to each other, that's it's very hard to put pressure and bring them even closer. This is because water has four main important properties, which are cohesiveness, molecular alignment, fluidity, and low coefficient of thermal expansion. First, let's understand how cohesiveness affects compressibility. Cohesiveness is the property of like molecules to attract each other. This is caused by the shape and structure of molecules, creating an electrical attraction between, leading to no space and gaps between the neighboring molecules. As the water is very cohesive, the molecular attraction leaves no gaps between it. So, when you try to compress it, as there is not enough space, it doesn't get compressed. Second thing is molecular alignment. Due to the cohesion, the molecules stuck to each other, but in very specific way, of tetrahedral configuration, which is like a pyramid, same as what we see in diamond structure. So, as the structure is same as diamond, you can think why it is hard to compress water. Third, fluidity. The intermolecular attraction of water is good, considering it's liquid, but not so good to make it a solid with tight bonds. Fluidity is the property to flow easily. It's inverse of viscosity. As water has good fluidity, meaning low viscosity, so when poured, all of its layers can mix into each other pretty easily. This enables lot of movement between the molecules, which enables them to move and adjust more easily. This fluidity helps molecules to align more easily in tetrahedral shapes, as there is very less resistance offered to its movement. Finally, low coefficient of thermal expansion. When substance is heated, it expands and its molecules go away from each other, increasing the volume. So, it's actually easier to compress a thermally expanded material as it has distance between its molecules. But water's coefficient of thermal expansion is very less and it expands very little when heated. So, even at high temperatures, you cannot compress the water much as there isn't any gap between the molecules. As the expansion is very little, when you try to compress it, you get compression to be very, very negligible. All of these properties of water makes it really hard to bring the molecules even closer so as to compress them. As it's really hard to compress water, we consider it as an incompressible liquid. If you learn something new, check out other videos on our channel and subscribe for the new ones. Also, make sure you hit the like button. If having any questions, feel free to mention them down in the comment section below. As of for now, I'm signing off and see you guys next week.